Damn, man. What it is, you guys? It's your boy Captain Former. We're back in the building to react to something I've been seeing floating around on the Star Wars YouTube interwebs that I feel like I need to react to. Obi-Wan has PTSD. I've seen a couple of YouTubers react to this one. The description reads, Obi-Wan faces his past when Luke Skywalker shows up on his doorstep. What I feel like it's going to do is going to take us back through scenes from The New Hope and a couple of other scenes through the prequels and pretty much just recap Obi-Wan's life. After seeing the original trilogy and the prequels, it's safe to say that Obi-Wan's been through a lot. He's definitely been the link or the bridge between the original and the prequel trilogy. So this should be interesting. I guess it's supposedly a very emotional video. I don't have any tissues handy right now, but I'm gonna do my best to hold it together, you guys. So without further ado.
Ben? Ben Kenobi? Boy, am I glad to see you.
I wonder why he started going by Ben.
Tell me, young Luke, what brings you out this far?
This little droid. I think he's searching for his former master, but I've never seen such emotion in a droid before.
I didn't know they knew each other before.
He claims to be the property of an Obi-Wan.
They're the only two people that know everything.
Is he a relative of yours? Do you know who he's talking about?
Obi-Wan Kenobi. Obi-Wan. Now that's a name I've not heard in a long time. Long time.
Aww.
I think my uncle knows him. He said he was dead.
Oh, he's not dead. Not yet.
Well, you know him?
Well, of course I know him. He's me. I haven't gone by the name of Obi-Wan since all before you were born.
Well, then, the droid does belong to you.
Don't seem to remember ever owning a droid. Very interesting. I think we better get indoors.
No, my father didn't fight in the wars. He was a navigator on a spice freighter.
That's what your uncle told you. He didn't hold with your father's ideals, thought he should have stayed here and not gotten involved.
You fought in the Clone Wars?
You don't even know, Luke. You don't even know the half of it.
Yes. I was once a Jedi Knight, the same as your father.
I wish I'd known him.
He was the best star pilot in the galaxy.
Aww, little Anakin. Aww.
And a cunning warrior.
Yeah, you could say that he was a cunning warrior.
And he was a good friend.
Aw, man.
Reminds me. I have something here for you. Your father wanted you to have this when you were old enough.
Oh yeah, I forgot. He gave him his lightsaber.
Your father's lightsaber. For over 1,000 generations, the Jedi Knights were the guardians of peace and justice in the Old Republic. Before the Dark Times.
Obi-Wan's seen a lot of death, man.
Before the Empire.
Man, look at him, man. He's like...
He's
traumatized. That's crazy. From the first movie,
Jedi named Darth Vader,
he embellished all these emotions.
His mind until he turned to evil. Helped the Empire hunt down and destroy the Jedi Knights.
Oh man! I'm still not over this Order 66, man. I'm still not over it. Obi-Wan's really messed up, man. You couldn't tell from the first movie.
Vader was seduced by the dark side of the Force. Now the Jedi are all but extinct.
Damn. Damn, man. That was rough. That was rough. I held it together, though. I held it together. What I'm most impressed by is the actor that played Obi-Wan in the first movie. Like, his performance, like, you could look in his eyes and you could see that he was, like, visualizing everything that happened in the prequels. You know what I mean? I don't know how far they wrote the Star Wars story at that point in time, so I don't know exactly how much they knew what was going to happen. But the actor took all the emotions from the prequels that happened, you know, years in the future, and took all those emotions from that character and put it into that first performance in the first movie. And that's just incredible to me that he could do that. Like, everything he was saying about the, you know, just Jedi Knights all being gone, like, it looked like he was envisioning Order 66, like, replaying in his head. Like, it was powerful. Wow, man, respect to that actor that played Obi-Wan in the original trilogy. Respect to all the Obi-Wan actors. All of them are really good. Respect to the dude that put this together. This was masterfully made. The music, the scene collection, all of it. Like, if you looked on his face, like, the man was having flashbacks to movies that didn't even happen yet. That's incredible. I feel like he wishes he was one of the Jedis that died in Order 66, which is the saddest part. Anyway, guys, that's going to do it for me. That's enough feels for the night. Let me know your thoughts on this fan video in the comments below. Don't forget to leave a like on this video, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next one. Peace!